Hello, my name is Podobna Elena, and I want to talk about fragmentation model for impact clusters on Mars. In recent years, about 1,200 of fresh dated meteoroid impact sites were discovered on Mars. They are crater fields and single clusters. Crater diameters vary from 1 meter due to camera resolution to almost 50 meters. Due to more rarefied Mars atmosphere in comparison with Earth, fallen meteoroids are less destroyed. On Earth, meteoroids are usually observed during the short flight through the atmosphere, and fragments are found in rare cases. Estimations of meteoroids' properties, among other things, depend on used fragmentation models calibrated on a small number of events. Mars surface level corresponds to about 30 kilometers altitude in the Earth atmosphere. So the study of clusters on Mars provide a unique opportunity to see results of less significant fragmentation. Here you can see some examples of fresh Martian impacts. Dark gray colors is fresh craters and clusters. And images are made by high-rise camera. In general, crater fields are of about from 50 to 500 meters. Based on the crater size, corresponding size of the impactor that formed it can be estimated using scaling relations. For each crater and cluster, corresponding impactor size was calculated. Due to deceleration in the atmosphere of the impactor, the same impactor create clusters of different size at different altitudes on Martian surface. With unknown entry angle, impactor velocity and impactor density, the accuracy of impactor diameter estimations are about 2 times. Impactors are up to 3 meters in diameter. Such impactors are observed on the Earth by bolide networks and satellite registration system. Previously, we used crater clusters to estimate the meteoroid trajectory. Almost 80 clusters with up to 465 craters were considered. Scattering ellipses like this and like this were used to estimate the inclination angle and the direction of flight. The picture shows two different methods of constructing scattering ellipses. Pluses are craters in current cluster, and the red ones are referred to largest quantile. The azimuth of meteoroid flight was determined as the inclination of the scattering ellipse. The direction of flight was chosen to the side from the center ellipse where total mass of the fragments is larger. Our estimates are in good agreement with independent estimates by Daubar and co-authors in 2019. Crater ejecta and the dark gray features on high-res images also can determine the direction of flight. On the pictures, you can see two arrows for meteoroid azimuth. Green shows meteoroid azimuth calculated by scattering ellipses, and red by meteoroid flight direction based on the ejecta features. The results are in agreement with independent estimate in some cases, but in half of cases, the direction of meteoroid flight didn't correlate. So the discrepancy between azimuth estimates requires other approaches. Next step was numerical modeling of meteoroid motion and fragmentation in both Martian and terrestrial atmospheres. Here you can see the model results for 1 meter impactor. You can see that the velocity of the impactor was sufficient to form craters from 4 to 13 meters in diameter. The ratio between crater sizes and the size of the strewn field, both are in good agreement with a real cluster on Mars. The ratio of the craters to the maximal one in model and in real cluster are close to each other. And due to the difference in the atmospheric densities, the same impactor, which we considered on the previous slide, forms a crater field on Earth that is many times bigger than on Mars. Also, we can see that fragments have the effect of atmospheric sorting on the Earth. It means that they line up along the trajectory by their masses. On Mars, with the effect is weak, strewn field is mainly determined by fragmentation and lateral spreading of fragments. And I want to highlight that fragmentation height on Earth is about 60 kilometers and on Mars is about 30. Meteoroid interaction with the atmosphere occurs in different flow regimes. Free molecular, transition, and continuous. Here you can see the equation for deceleration during the meteoroid motion, and this is the drag coefficient. It depends on flow regime, velocity, and the shape of the meteoroid fragment. There are many different equations for the drag coefficient in different flow regimes. We choose some, you can see them in the table, and consider the variation of the drag coefficient during the meteoroid motion. For the continuous regime, there are two different formulas which were compared. All equations are given for a spherical impactor. Implemented fragmentation model should work equally well in the atmospheres of both Mars and Earth, and for fragments of different sizes. Drag coefficient is important for meter and submeter scaled meteoroids of on both Mars and Earth. For Earth, due to the dense atmosphere, the transition to subsonic is important, especially for determining the location of meteoroid's fall. Considered 1 meter meteoroid in the Earth's atmosphere fragments into spheres of a different diameter. On the pictures, you can see the results of variation of drag coefficient during the meteoroid motion. Here you can see for the minimal fragment, 0.3 centimeters, and the bottom the bottom panels are for maximal fragment. It's almost about 1 meter. The left and right panels differ by different equations for continuum regime, continuous regime. Other equations for other regimes are identical. We can see that on left panels, the transition between subsonic and hypersonic velocities is wider than on right picture panels. And Also, it should be mentioned that on the most part of the meteoroid trajectory, I forgot to say that the axes are height and velocity. On the most part of the meteoroid trajectory.
5 minutes.
The drag coefficient value is about one. Black line referred to meteoroid motion in height and velocity axis. My summary is given on slide, but I want to highlight that preliminary results showed that developed fragmentation model would allow to describe clusters and to suggest better methods for estimation of light direction and impactor properties. Thank you for your attention.